Today, we are going to be talking about sound alerts and different ways that you can trigger them in order to make your live stream more interactive and just more fun to watch. This is accessible for streamers on Twitch, YouTube, and other platforms, but we're going to focus on Twitch today. I'm going to show you how to let your chat trigger sound alerts using channel points. We're also going to set it up so that they can use bits. We're even going to have it so that it plays a specific sound when a very special viewer comes in. Now, make sure you watch till the end because there's a bunch of options that I just can't mention in the intro. So in order to do all that and more, we're going to be using Blerp.com, which is actually the sponsor of this video. So here we are on Blerp.com. We're going to click top right on login, and we're going to log in with our Twitch account for this tutorial. You can log in with anything you want. Set up your username, put your info, and just click continue, and boom, you're going to have your own Blerp account, unlocking a lot of options for you. From here, you can click on Twitch dashboard, and it's going to show us the three main options that we talked about: channel points, bits extension, Walkon. And then Walkon is that thing that I told you would play a sound when someone comes in. From here, we're going to set up the channel points. We're going to click grant channel access. This is basically going to give access to Blerp to our Twitch account in order to create those channel point rewards. Then you can click on new reward in order to create a brand new channel point reward to trigger that specific alert that you're going to add. You're going to have access to the whole library here. There's over a million sounds, so you're going to be scrolling forever if you were trying to listen to all of them. You can filter them by many ways, but here we're just going to try to find some quick ways to listen to a couple of previews. Bro, mamma
mia. I am inside your walls.
So once you find a sound that you're satisfied with, you can click on the little plus, and here you will have the options to set up that new channel point reward. You're gonna have the title, you're gonna have how many channel point you want it to cost. There's color and description, but that is a premium option. We can set up the channel cooldown here, and then there's limit per stream, limit per user per stream. And here we can copy the browser source link. We're gonna have another option to copy it later. Right here, actually, it's gonna walk you through the whole process of setting it up, and it won't continue if you don't set it up properly. For example, here, it says, hey, I didn't detect the browser source. So we're gonna go in OBS, we're gonna click on new source browser, and we're gonna copy paste that link right here. Click OK, and now it should detect it, and we're gonna see that it says yes, browser detected, we're good to go, and it's gonna test it here. Okay, now you can say I heard it. That means everything is working fine, and you can just continue, and boom, here you are, your little dashboard for your sound effect channel point rewards. You can see I have a bunch that are deactivated because I used to use Blerp a while back, and I have a bunch of them. If you want to add a new one, just click add a new reward at the bottom here. Wow. Listen to a few more, click plus to add them, set up how many channel points you want it to cost, set up the cooldown, add reward, you're good to go because you already have the browser source link. You can see the second one appears on the list right here. Now I'm gonna go ahead and basically activate an old one. You can see what it's like to basically activate one that is not currently active. And here I can change on the fly, I can change how many channel points I want it to cost.
In the beginning,
All right, let's go back to dashboard to just take a look at what we have left. You can see channel points, and then there's bits. We can click explore to actually get that set up. It's super fast, super easy. Click next, and here we can set up a general bit amount, keeping in mind that you can also set them up individually later. Channel cooldown, so every 60 seconds, I want people to be able to trigger one. And then I have the Twitch extension options. There's overlay extensions, and then there's panel extensions. Here, I'm choosing overlay extensions because this is what I recommend, this is what I prefer, but later on I will put a panel just so I can show you basically what Blerp is gonna look like once it's on your channel. At the bottom here, you're gonna see there is a rating system. If you don't want anything that is 18 plus types of sound on your stream, you can set that up to be even just 7 plus, just PG, and not even PG-13. I think that's a great way to prevent having, you know, more adult focused sound effects be triggered on your family friendly stream.
Good job.
And at the bottom, of course, we can add a brand new Blerp. So that's play, of course, to preview them, and then plus to add them. In this case, it's all going to be managed through the extension, so you don't have to set them up individually. We already set them up to be 25 or 50 bits in my case per sound. So I have everything set up, and I wanted to test the collection. So at the bottom, I'm going to click add collection, add new, and I'm going to create a new selection, which is going to be my favorite sounds. I'm even going to upload a collection cover, if you will. That way I can pick a specific set of sounds that match that collection, and it will be displayed to the viewers. They will have the choice to actually pick those specific sounds. You can have multiple collections, as you can see, and they will all appear here on your extension preview or extension dashboard, if you will. You can also favorite some sounds, and they are going to be pinned at the top, so people will have access to it easily. Now the third setup is the walk-on. You can just click at the bottom right for turn on walk-on. And here you can set up the cooldown, and we're gonna set it to 1 day. Basically every day, every 24 hours, I will have a specific sound play for a specific viewer, or I can set it up so that any tier one sub can even pick which sound they want to play, and they can basically submit it to me and I can accept it or refuse it or set a specific sound for them. That's it. For example, here I search for Viking Trash, which I know is sub to me, and I'm gonna even set her as a quote unquote VIP, which means that even when she's unsubbed, I will be able to still play a sound for her every time she walks on.
Yeah. You silly goose, you're so silly.
I'm gonna find a sound that I know will resonate with her, and I'm gonna add that one. And just like that, every 24 hours when Viking comes up to my chat, this sound will play to her first message. The settings tab will help you have a good grasp on what is activated, what is not, and if there's any issue with it, you can basically go back and set it up properly. For example, for the extension setup links, I can just click on view extensions, and it's gonna bring me to my extensions on my Twitch dashboard. And as you can see, I already have Blerp activated as component one. Component one usually means it's as an overlay, as we chose earlier, but I'm gonna go to my panels, and I'm actually gonna click edit panels, and I'm gonna add a new extension panel. Click extension panel, of course, and it's gonna bring you back to the extension manager, and we're gonna set up Blerp to be a panel. We're gonna set it up as panel one, actually. Right there, click here and set as panel one. And this will show up as panel one, and it's gonna be the Blerp extension. And we're gonna finally have a good look at what our viewers are going to see. So you can see there's multiple tabs within the extension showing us the top Blerps and a lot of categories, top 10 Blerps. They will also see our collections if they click on channel. They will see the most trending Blerps and things like that. They can preview them, actually listen to them, and then decide if they wanna give the bits to play it on your stream. Keeping in mind that you have it as a browser source, so it will play on your stream no matter what they choose. The cool thing that I love with this extension is that it actually gives a lot of freedom to the user. They can see normal Blerps, they can see your Blerps, your top Blerps, they can see your collection, but they can also set up their own collections. They can also go and log in with their Twitch account and actually manage their own library for your stream and for other streams too. So you can see they have access to a menu here with the walk-on, the channel points, and all that. So for the overlay, this is where it's gonna show on the screen, and I believe it's also accessible from mobile. And for the channel points, of course, you can see the ones that we set up. The three ones are right there, and they are in the typical Blerp color, so people really can't miss them. A little trick I like to do in order to hear it is go to the browser source and set up control audio via OBS, and then you'll see it appear here on the mixer. So if something is too loud, you can turn it down here. And then go to advanced audio property and find Blerp, and make sure you set it to monitor only and mute the output. That way you can hear it, and it will also be picked up by your desktop audio. That's just my way of making sure that I can hear, but also I can control the volume on the fly. And there it is. Congrats. You just set up sound effects for your live stream. And now your viewers can cause you
emotional damage.
And that's just how simple it is to set up sound alerts for bits, channel points, and the walk-on extension. So you should go on and try Blerp today using my affiliate link in the description. I'll also have their Discord link in the description in case you have any questions or experiencing any difficulties. All that being said, make sure you follow me on Twitch, and thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Go out there, make me proud, get a level, out.